Gentlelady is recognized.
Thank you very much, Mr. Speaker. I thank the distinguished gentleman, the chair of the Budget Committee, for yielding, and I thank him for bringing this excellent document to the floor, a budget which will help us protect our country, grow our economy, give middle-income tax cuts, and to do so in a fiscally sound way. Mr. Speaker, as we all know, our budget is a statement of our national values. At least it should be. And now, for the first time in our new direction, Congress, last year and this year, for 2 years straight, we have put forth a budget resolution. The first time a budget resolution has been put forth in an election year by this Congress since the Republicans took over. Now the Democrats are in charge. 2 years of responsible budgeting. I listened with interest to our colleagues and their views on this budget, and they certainly are entitled to their opinion. But they are not entitled to their own set of facts. I want to just quote from some of the responsible independent budget organizations. Some of them are conservative or leaning organizations when it comes to their false claim about this budget increasing taxes. The Committee for Responsible Federal Budget says the conference agreement does not raise taxes. The Hamilton Project of the Brookings Institution says very clearly the budget would not raise taxes. Indeed, your budget, Mr. Spratt, indicates that one of your priorities is making upfront cuts in taxes for alternative minimum tax relief that ultimately would be paid for without increasing the budget deficit. And the Center for Budget and Policy Priorities says, some claim that the budget plan of the conferees would constitute the largest tax increase in history. That claim is inaccurate. This year's budget plan does not include a tax increase. It actually calls for a $340 billion tax reduction in revenues. The problem that our friends on the Republican side have is that these tax cuts are for the middle class, not just for their friends in the upper 1% bracket. These tax cuts are cutting the address the marriage penalty, address the 10% tax bracket, the child tax credit. The middle class and those who aspire to it benefit from this budget. This is a fiscally sound budget, and for that we are all in Mr. Spratt's debt. This budget has to be balanced in terms of its spending, its priorities, and indeed it is a statement of our values. I would like to see everyone in this room who supports veterans to say they cannot support the budget provisions in this legislation. In this bill, our veterans, it provides an additional $3.7 billion for veterans health care and services, which is why this budget has the strong support of major veterans groups. When it comes to energy, an issue of major concern to households across America, this budget provides $7.7 billion for renewable energy, energy efficiency, and other energy initiatives, which is $2.7 billion more than just last year. And innovation. Let's stop having these stale debates about trade or no trade. Let's educate, innovate, compete, and prevail in the global marketplace. And this provides nearly $2 billion to fully accommodate the commitments made in the America Competes Act, which was voted on by an overwhelming number of Republicans to give us a huge vote in the Congress and signed by the President. And this is to spur innovation and invest in basic science and scientific innovation. But again, by setting the right priorities and making tough choices, our budget also cuts taxes again for the middle class and those aspiring to it, and protects 20 million households from the alternative minimum tax. In any year, creating a budget is a difficult challenge. In an election year, it is even more challenging because of all of the competing priorities that want to be in the budget. But this year, we have a budget that is in balance in terms of its values, is in balance in terms of the track that it puts us on. Thank you, Mr. Spratt, for putting us on track to be in with no deficit, the budget to be in balance by 2012. It is fully compliant with pay-as-you-go rules. It is a budget, again, of the statement of our values, fiscally responsible, pay-as-you-go. It has tremendous merit, and it should have the support of every person in this body. I urge a yes vote on the budget and yield back the balance of my time. Thank you.